Got some news for you guys today. Guess what? Japan just achieved internet speeds so fast, you could download Netflix's entire library in under 1 second. I love this type of stuff. I'm talking about internet speeds that are literally 4 million times faster than your home internet. This isn't science fiction. This just happened in 2025, and it's about to change everything we know about the internet forever. I love technology advances. Hey everyone, today we are going to be diving into the most insane internet speed breakthrough that's breaking the laws of what we thought was possible. We're talking about Japan's latest achievement that's making headlines worldwide. The speed record so mind-blowing that it could download the entire internet archive in just 4 minutes. But here's the crazy part. They did it using cables that are the exact same thickness as the ones we use today. But to truly understand just how revolutionary this breakthrough is, we need to take a little bit of a journey through the incredible evolution of internet speeds. And trust me, by the end of this video, you'll realize just how we're witnessing one of the biggest technological leaps in human history. Let's go back to where it all began. If you're old enough to remember dial-up internet, you'll remember that painful screech of the connection dial-up gave us a whopping 56 kilobits per second. At that speed, downloading a single 3-minute song took, calculations claim 15 minutes, but I remember it being much longer. A single photo, much longer than that, and you couldn't even watch videos. Now, to put this in perspective, at dial-up speeds, downloading a modern 4K movie would take 6 months of nonstop downloading. 6 months. And that's assuming nothing went wrong and nobody picked up the phone. Then came the broadband revolution in the early 2000s. DSL and cable internet brought us speeds of 1 to 10 megabits per second. Suddenly, we were 20 to even 200 times faster than dial-up. This was when YouTube became possible, when we could actually download music in minutes instead of what felt like hours and could have even literally been hours. By 2010, we were seeing speeds of 25 to 100 megabits per second becoming a lot more common. Netflix streaming became a reality, video calls stopped being a choppy nightmare, and we thought we were living in the future. Then, fiber optic internet started rolling out to homes, bringing gigabit speeds, 1,000 megabits per second. Suddenly, downloading entire movies took minutes instead of hours, and we thought this was as fast as the internet would ever need to be. So, where do we stand today in 2025? The global average internet speed is around 60 megabits per second, but there's huge variation. In the US, the average is about 289 megabits per second. South Korea leads the world with average speeds around 500 megabits per second. The fastest widely available consumer internet in the world right now, that's in places like Singapore and again South Korea, where you can get 10 gigabits per second to your home. That's 10,000 megabits per second. Incredibly fast by today's standards. But here's what's crazy. Even these blazing fast consumer speeds pale in comparison to what's happening in research labs and backbone internet infrastructure right now. Because over the past few years, researchers have been pushing the absolute limits on what's possible with fiber optics. In 2024, scientists at Aston University in the UK achieved 402 terabits per second. That's 402,000 gigabits per second. We thought that was mind-blowing. Other labs have achieved similar speeds over short distances. The key limitation has always been distance. Sure, you can achieve incredible speeds over a few kilometers in a lab, but can you maintain those speeds over hundreds or thousands of kilometers? That's the real challenge for practical internet infrastructure. Now let me blow your mind with what Japan just achieved. They reached 1.02 petabits per second. That's over 125,000 gigabytes per second. Let's put this in perspective with our journey through internet history. That's 18 million times faster than dial-up internet, 3.5 million times faster than today's average US internet speeds, and 100,000 times faster than the fastest consumer internet available today. With 2.5 times faster than that previous lab record. Here's the kicker. They didn't just achieve this speed in a lab over a short distance. They maintained it over 1,808 kilometers. That's like sending data from New York to Florida or from London to Rome at these absolutely insane speeds. To understand how monumental this is, let's look at the progression of internet speed records, okay? Bear with me. In 2020, lab speeds reached around 44 terabits per second. In 2022, researchers achieved 100 plus terabits per second over short distances. In 2024, what we just talked about, the UK team hit 402 terabits per second, short distances. And in 2025, Japan just achieved 1,020 terabits per second over 1,800 plus kilometers. Notice something? We're not seeing gradual improvements anymore. We're seeing exponential leaps. The jump from 2024 to 2025 alone represents more than a 150% increase in speed achieved over a distance nearly 30 times longer than previous records. This isn't just incremental improvement. This is a paradigm shift. It's like going from the first airplane to supersonic jet in the span of a single year. Have I already told you how much I love technology? Here's why the distance component is absolutely crucial here. Anyone can achieve high speeds, like I said, over those short distances. It's similar to sprinting 100 meters versus running a marathon. The real engineering challenge that we have been pushing up against is maintaining signal integrity, preventing data loss, and managing interference over vast distances. Previous record holders could achieve petabit speeds, but only over 60 to 100 kilometers. Japan now proved you can maintain these speeds over a large distance with minimal data loss. That's the difference between a cool lab experiment and technology that could actually revolutionize global internet structure. To appreciate this breakthrough a little bit more, you need to understand how fiber optics work. Traditional fiber optic cables are incredibly thin strands of glass, thinner than human hair, and they carry light signals. Data is encoded through pulses of light that travel through these glass fibers at nearly the speed of light. The problem is each traditional cable has just one core, one pathway for light to travel. It's like having a single lane highway for all your data traffic. Sure, you can make cars go faster, but you're fundamentally limited to having just one lane. What the Japanese team did was revolutionary because instead of one core, they created a fiber with 19 cores, essentially 19 parallel highways for light signals all squeezed into the exact same space as a traditional single core fiber. The cable is just 0.125 millimeters thick, and it's the same thickness as the current cables. But here's the genius part. It's not just about having 19 times more capacity. The way they designed these cores is crucial. All 19 cores interact with light in exactly the same way, which means there's virtually no interference between them. It's like having 19 perfectly synchronized lanes where cars never bump into each other or slow each other down. They called this coupled multi-core fiber technology, and it required solving incredibly complex engineering challenges. How do you prevent light signals in one core from interfering with signals in adjacent cores? How do you ensure all 19 pathways maintain the same signal quality over 1,800 kilometers? You see how this wasn't that easy? I mean, here's another engineering marvel. Maintaining signal strength over such massive distances. Light signals naturally weaken as they travel, especially over hundreds of kilometers. The team had to amplify the signal 21 times along the 1,800 kilometer journey. By amplifying 19 separate light signals simultaneously without creating interference or distortion, that's like conducting a 19-piece orchestra where every musician is playing in a different room and you need to make sure they all stay perfectly in sync. The precision required is absolutely mind-blowing. Have I mentioned I love technology? So why does this matter for you and me though? So we're rapidly approaching what experts call the Internet of Everything era. By 2030, there will be an estimated 75 billion connected devices, maybe too many, but 75 billion nonetheless worldwide. That's 10 devices for every person on Earth. Your car will be constantly communicating with traffic systems, other cars, and navigation satellites. Your smartphone will have dozens of connected devices. Virtual and augmented reality will become as common as smartphones, and AI systems will be processing massive data sets in real time. All of this will generate an absolutely explosive amount of data traffic. Current estimates suggest we'll need internet infrastructure capable of handling 1,000 times more data than today's networks by 2035. Without breakthroughs like this Japanese achievement, our digital future would hit a massive bottleneck. So imagine what becomes possible with this technology. For example, global cloud computing with data centers on different continents could operate as if they're in the same building. A server in Tokyo could process data from New York with zero noticeable delay. Real-time global collaboration where scientists could share massive research data sets instantly across continents. And a medical breakthrough in Japan could be analyzed by researchers worldwide in real time. Even next-generation entertainment, 8K, 16K, or even higher resolution content could stream instantly. Virtual reality experiences so realistic they're indistinguishable from reality. Now, could our eyes see 16K? I don't think so. We'll find out, I guess. You even have autonomous everything. Self-driving cars, drones, and robots could communicate with perfect coordination across vast networks, making them exponentially safer and more efficient. Things like scientific research and projects like the Large Hadron Collider could generate petabytes of data. With this technology, that data could also be analyzed by supercomputers worldwide instantly, accelerating scientific discovery. Now, there's something to be said with how much we might be dependent on a lot of these systems, but that's not the topic of this video. Because here's the beautiful part. This isn't just a lab curiosity that would require rebuilding the entire internet. These 19 core fibers are the exact same diameter as current cables, which means they could potentially be deployed using existing infrastructure. All those underground conduits, all those fiber routes already installed, they could accommodate these new super cables without massive reconstruction projects. This means the path to deployment is much more realistic than if they had to dig up every street in the world or dig up those cables running under the ocean. Just even the economic implications are staggering. Countries and companies that can deploy this technology first will have massive competitive advantages. Imagine if your country had internet infrastructure 1,000 times better than your competitors. The economic growth potential is beyond enormous. Japan is already known for having some of the world's best internet infrastructure. With breakthroughs like this, they're positioning themselves to lead the global digital economy for decades to come. But let's be realistic, this technology isn't coming to your home next year, sadly. There are still significant challenges to overcome, but I want it now. One of those being cost. These specialized fibers are currently extremely expensive to manufacture. Scaling and producing them at global scale will require massive manufacturing investments. With signal processing, the equipment to handle 19 simultaneous signals is incredibly complex. And then you look at standards. Global telecommunication standards need to be updated to support this technology. But realistically, when could we see this rolling out to the public? Based on historical pattern of telecom technology and technology deployment, we're probably looking at 2027, major telecom companies will probably start testing this technology. And then somewhere between 2028 to 2030, you might see early deployment in critical backbone infrastructure. By 2030 to 2035, gradual rollout to major data centers and international links will probably start happening. And 2035 to 2040, potential availability for high-end commercial applications. Consumer applications, probably not until the 2040s, which is a bummer. But the infrastructure benefits will trickle down long before then, making everyone's internet faster and more reliable. I want it now. Japan also isn't the only country pushing these boundaries. There's an intense international competition happening. In the United States, major tech companies and universities are heavily investing in next generation fiber research. China has massive government investment in advanced telecommunications infrastructure, and the European Union has collaborative research programs across multiple countries. South Korea is already leading in consumer internet speeds, pushing for next generation infrastructure. So this Japanese breakthrough definitely puts them significantly ahead, but the competition is beyond fierce. Whoever dominates this technology will likely dominate the global digital economy. And control of advanced internet infrastructure is becoming as strategically important as something like oil or electricity generation. Companies with superior internet infrastructure will attract more businesses, enable more innovation, and have stronger economies. So this is why governments worldwide are treating advanced telecommunications as a matter of national security and economic competitiveness. So let's step back today and appreciate the magnitude of what we've just witnessed. In the span of human history, we went from sending messages by horseback to achieving internet speeds that are literally 4 million times faster than what people have today. But more than that, this breakthrough represents the foundation for technologies that we can barely imagine. Just like the invention of the transistor enabled the computer revolution, this advancement in fiber optics could enable technological revolutions we haven't even conceived yet. So while you and I won't see these speeds anytime soon, this breakthrough will improve your digital life in countless ways. Faster cloud services, better video streaming, more responsive online gaming, and emerging technologies that simply wouldn't be possible without this kind of infrastructure. We are standing at the beginning of a new era of human connectivity. The internet as we know it is about to be completely transformed, and Japan just showed us what the future looks like. But what do you think about these incredible speeds? Can you imagine what becomes possible when data can travel anywhere on Earth instantly? Are you like me and you wish we could have this already? Or is this something that you don't care about? Let me know in the comments below. And what would you do with internet that's 4 million times faster than what we have now? Anyway, that's all I've got for you today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Feel free to like if you liked this video and subscribe if you want more updates on technology, games, or even entertainment. I'd love to have you. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day. Peace out. Bye.